response to yes, Lord. Don't miss it. They said yes, Lord. And there's an immediate response from their yes, Lord. Y'all ain't helping me. They say yes, Lord. And there's an immediate response to their yes. They say yes, Lord.
Yes.
And there's an immediate response to their yes.
Amen. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Because now here's where I'm challenged in the text. When Jesus talks to Simon and tell him to let down the net, we really don't know if Simon is in the boat with him. Because the argument stands as this. He says to Peter earlier, push me out a little further.
That's what he said.
Push out into the deep. I'm in your boat. But I want you to put the net on the boat and launch me out into the deep. Where are you going with this? Sometimes you feel like you got to be in the boat with Jesus. When Jesus says, I don't need you in the boat, I just need you connected to the boat.
Now that's Jesus right there.
The net. Fish come from everywhere. It's so much fish coming that it breaks their net. When you look at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
your next yes
is going to be a net breaking miracle. The blessing is so massive. Get this out of here. Come on, let's go. The blessing is so massive that it breaks their net. Their net is breaking, but they got all of their supply. Their net is breaking, but they got increase and overflow. Their net is breaking, but they got so much that they started calling their boys. Come help us get this. You come on and get this. Could it be that your yes, Lord, is about to bless your brother? Your yes, Lord, is about to bless your sister. Your yes, Lord, is about to bless your enemies. Your yes, Lord, is about to bless your haters. Look at somebody and say, there's a yes in my spirit. I feel a networking blessing about to hit my life. And when I get blessed, you gon' get blessed. When I get mad, you gon' get yours. Because I told God yes. Yes to your will. Yes to your word. Yes to your word. Yes all the day. I got a yes in my spirit. Miracle to happen in our life. I feel on the inside. And whether or not you want to say yes, I'll say yes. Yes, Lord, to your will. Yes, Lord, to your way. Yes, Lord, to your word. Nevertheless, at your word, I'm going to do it again. I know it's been 63 years of ministry. Some of y'all been here all 63. Some of y'all been here 53. Some of y'all been here 43. 33 and 23. 13 and 3. Some of y'all only been here 3 months. But there ought to be a yes in your spirit. Because you can't stop now. You got to launch out just a little bit further and go out into the deep. Because there's a greater catch. There's a greater catch of souls that will take place. There's a harvest of souls waiting on Mount Bethel. Good night, Mount Bethel. God bless you real good. And is there anybody in here feel like praising God? Because you see a harvest coming. You see a miracle coming. You see a blessing coming. Now open up your mouth and give it praise. Give it glory. Jesus to say no to you. Bishop, I asked you to do certain things. Well, you know, Bishop, that's really not fitting in my schedule. You want to know why you can't ink that deal? You want to know why you're not able to sign that contract? Could it be that you've been saying no so much that you're closing the door on your own? Because God takes Mount Bethel even higher and launch you out even further into the deep. Change your wording from no to yes. It's a miracle. It's an interesting thing because when you read all the way down to the 11th verse, after the miracle takes place, the first thing they do, they fall on their knees and they begin to worship. And then Jesus speaks into their lives and say, look, because they're talking about how unworthy they are. They can't stand. The Message translation says, we can't stand all of this holiness. We are unworthy to be around you. Jesus says, hey, don't be afraid. Stop tripping. Because just like you caught these fish, I'm now going to cause you to become fishers of men. And here's verse 11. And they forsook all to follow Jesus. When was the last time you say, I have decided to follow Jesus? The world behind me, the cross before me. You can have this whole world, but give me Jesus. No turning back. No turning back. They forsook all to follow Jesus. How many miracles is it going to take for you to really forsake all? How many times does God have to heal your body and make the way out of nowhere when you really give me a real yes? And they forsake all to follow Jesus. Mount Bethel, please. preach in my heart tonight. Don't let the trappings of this world jack up your yes. And watch this. And even when you get in your night of struggle, don't let your night of struggle dictate whether you say yes or no. Keep saying yes, even in the midst of the pressure.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Keep saying yes when tears are running down.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And it seems like it won't come together, but I'm telling you, your yes is not only going to be your blessing, but any and everybody who's connected to you or this ministry will be blessed by this community and sing nothing yet. For this community and sing nothing yet. Flipping on a couple of y'all meetings and y'all supposed to be going out west and seeing nothing yet. I don't care who's coming to town. Now, Bethel, all y'all got to do is say yes. And watch what God does. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Lord, I've done what you told me to do. I've given them the word. Now, God, I know it's on them, but I pray that you will massage their hearts, their minds, their souls, their spirits. Some of them are tired. Some of them have been working for so many years in ministry. They're tired, but God, I pray that you will give them the strength and the fortitude. In fact, God, give them the grace for their assignment to go a little further in the deep. And that God, they will say yes to your will, drop their net and experience an incredible miracle like never before. You're not through with them yet. You're not through with Bishop and Lady Glover yet. And so God, we thank you. We honor you and we praise you for our future in the faith. Father, tonight we say nevertheless, at your word, we will let down. And we expect that the best is yet to come. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Everybody love God, say amen. Amen. Can you open up your mouth and release praise unto our God? Amen. Bishop's permission, if you don't know Jesus, in the pardon of your sin, and maybe you showed up tonight, heard it was church going on, but you heard this chocolate dude up there talking about Jesus. You say, man, I gotta nevertheless, I want to drop my neck. I want to surrender to you. I got a yes in my spirit. You don't have a relationship with him tonight, you can make Jesus your choice. Give your life to him. So if that's you, come down, give this preacher your hand. Give one of these incredible men up here in your hand, but give God your heart. That's number one. Number two, maybe you walk away from God. Maybe you're in a backslidden state. But God is never to backslide. He never left you. You just left him. But he says, I'm like AT&T in the Jackson 5. I want you back. So that's you. Come on back. And then number three, maybe you're looking for a church home. Mount Bethel is a good place. It's wonderful. People, wonderful pastor, wonderful first lady. There's a lot of churches around this place. And there's a lot of people who go to different churches. But I'll tell you what I know about this house. This is a good house.
Amen.
It's a great house for you to be in. So maybe if you're looking for a church home, this is where you need to be. So if that's you, come on. I've extended a threefold invitation. If that's you, wherever you are, get up out of your seat. Come down the aisle. We'll love on you. We'll pray with you. We'll get some information from you.